In this video, we're going to take a look at random questions in the all-new Adobe Captivate. I'm Paul Wilson, and I make YouTube videos about e-learning, specifically Adobe Captivate. If you like what I'm doing here on my channel, by all means, subscribe. Don't forget to like this video, and feel free to share this video with all of your e-learning buddies. Today, we're going to look at random questions in the all-new Adobe Captivate. With the release of Update 12.4, random questions have come back to Adobe Captivate, and in a big way, of course. You have access to the same old question pools that you could create before, although the user interface is greatly improved. And also, there's a little bonus, and for those that watch this video right to the end, you'll learn about a secret feature that really improves this feature. Let's get started. Okay, to understand random question slides in Adobe Captivate, you also need to understand question pools. Because while you can have a random question slide in your main project, it needs to pull those questions from somewhere. And in Adobe Captivate, that's from question pools. There are two ways that you can start working with question pools. You can click on the window drop-down menu and select question pool to take you directly into the question pool editor. Or you can start by adding random question slides, which will generate your first question pool. It'll be empty, of course, but you'll be able to add questions to it once you've gotten into the question pool editor. So let's click on new slide. We'll go down to random, so we're creating a random question. It really is just a placeholder slide, so you'll see this here, and it's now associated with pool number one, which is a completely empty set of questions stored in a pool. We can go ahead and edit that question pool. So the very first thing we need to do with working with pool number one is we need to now import some questions or create some questions. Creating questions is easy. You can just click on the plus icon in the left-hand toolbar and select multiple choice, true, false, matching, short answer, or sequence. But I'm going to show you a different way that I think is going to be more likely what you're going to use, and that's the ability to import CSV or comma-separated value files. This is a way you can write out all your questions in advance into what is essentially an Excel spreadsheet file and then import it all at once. I have a separate video on this, and you can follow that in the upper right-hand corner here and watch that video now or at a later time. Let's go ahead and press Import CSV. Now, I've created two CSV files. Let's say this e-learning project is a little bit about the United States, and we've got a learning objective that covers the history of the United States, and we have a separate learning objective that covers geography of the United States. So let's start with history. I'm going to choose history and click on open. And this will now import all of the questions that I've set up in that CSV file. Again, you can watch the other video if you want to learn how to do that. So that takes care of pool number one. One of the things that you might wish to do is name your question pools. So if you click on the ellipses icon here, you can rename this pool. And we're going to call this, obviously, what it's associated with here, U.S. History. Click Done. Now, I'm going to create my geography question pool. To do that, click on this plus icon up here on the top toolbar. Select Create a Pool. And we can do what we did before and click the plus icon on the left-hand toolbar and choose Import CSV. And I'll choose Geography and then click Open. So now I have two question pools, one with history, one with geography. That's all well and good. Let's rename question pool two before we go away from this, and we will call this US Geography. There we go. Click Done. One of the things that happens when you have two or more question pools is you have the ability now to delete one of those question pools. I'm not going to do so in this case, but I just wanted to point out that you could delete either one of the pools that you have. And of course, you can select the pool that you're currently looking at just by using this drop down here. Let's go back to U.S. history for a moment. Let's say your stakeholder has asked you to always have one of the questions from U.S. history to always be present for your learners to see. Maybe they're a big George Washington fan, and they want to make sure that everyone is asked the question, who was the first president of the United States? So I can right-click on this slide here, and you'll notice that there's a move to option. I can do one of two things. I can either move it to another question pool if I wanted to, or in this case, I'm going to select project to move it to the main project. Let's exit from the question pool manager here and return back to our main project here. I'm going to delete this blank slide up front. And for the question that we just moved out of the question pool and into the main project, let's make that the first question that we always see. So here we have random question one. It is tied to U.S. history, but by using this drop-down selector here, I could change that to U.S. geography. Let's duplicate this slide. So now I have two questions that are tied to U.S. history. But for this purpose here, I'm going to change the second one to be tied to U.S. geography. So if I need, in this case, 9 questions from U.S. geography, I would like 5 of them to come from that particular pool. I can do one of several things. I can either click on the new slide icon and select another random question and then tie it to the U.S. geography, or I can simply press Control D and make 5 in total of these random question slide tied to U.S. geography. Now I need 5 questions from U.S. history. I already have one here, so I'm only going to duplicate this one 4 times, but just to give you a view of how this works, I'm going to click on plus, and we'll choose random here. There's my second random, and of course we'll tie that to U.S. history. The default is always your first question pool, but you could certainly change that if you wish. And in this case here, I'm going to duplicate this 2 more times. Now let's preview this project here, and we'll take a look at it. Okay, so we're seeing our first question one here. Who was the first president of the United States? We know that's George Washington. Everyone is always going to get this as the first question, because remember, we moved this question from one of our question pools into the main project. And again, that might be something a stakeholder has asked for. So let's go ahead and press submit and move on from here. So question 2, Civil War question, having to do with slavery. Question 3, Cold War question. We'll just remember those first 2 or 3. This is between the United States and the Soviet Union. And question 4, Great Depression, 1930s. I'm going to get the rest of these wrong, just on purpose here, because I want to be presented with the retake quiz option at the end here. All right, so I've failed this. Let's retake the quiz. Obviously, we're going to see the George Washington question first, because that is outside of the random question pool. The Industrial Revolution began in which country? Aha! So we're seeing a different question 2 than what we saw before. In this case, Great Britain here. Question 3, who was the president of the United States during World War II? FDR. Kind of good news for some, maybe not so good news for others. But the long and the short of it is now, and this was something a lot of people were very vocal about in prior versions of Adobe Captivate, is that random question slides were only random per instance that a learner was taking a course. So if they retook the quiz, they would see the exact same questions. Now we're seeing different questions on retaking the quiz. So that's kind of good news. I think it allows for a little bit more diversity in that quiz here. So let's finish answering this here. Declaration of Independence. Always got to get a Canada question in there, of course, because I'm from Canada. Mount McKinley, Lake Superior, Arizona, I think. Yep. Missouri River. And there we go, 100%. And of course, I could review the quiz because I've successfully completed it. I don't want to retake it anymore. And of course, now I can continue with the rest of my e-learning project.
If you thought this video was helpful, please like and share it with your colleagues. If you need help with Adobe Captivate, hire Paul for one-on-one instruction. Paul's goal is to focus on lessons based on your specific needs. Visit his website at CaptivateTeacher.com. And don't forget to subscribe to his YouTube channel.